bring Western influences to Japan. How did you move on that, and what type of research did you do?
I used to live in Los Angeles, and I still keep a house here. And I'm actually a filmmaker, go back and forth. So basically, that Omura's character is some kind of extension of myself. And I always researched that period, the 1870s, as a filmmaker, and always wanted to make those movies. So, and particularly one historical character named Kido, Lord Kido. I'm a big fan of this guy. So this Omura character is an amalgam of those Kido and several others who made the who dispatched by the government for the first time to see Europe and in the States.
Right.
There's about 30 or 40 characters. And I was always fascinated with the experience of those people. And there's so many books written about them, and some of them, for example, Lord Kido himself wrote a diary of that trip. Yeah. So I read those and put them together, and yeah, that's actually what Ed wanted me to do that. And also, all those stories about Lord Kido and those great characters in Meiji era, I heard from my grandfather. And my grandfather's last name was, just by coincidence, Omura.
Really?
And his first name is Matsue. And so when I was cast, before I was cast, this Omura character was Prince Omura. And when Ed got me, for some reason I lost the title Prince. But instead I got the first name. So I asked Ed, can I use my grandfather's name? And he accepted it. And so I'm playing my grandfather's name.
Do you think it stays real faithful to the culture?
Oh, yes, yes. And particularly in the area of the manner of the courtroom. Emperor's courtroom, and it's very faithful to that era. And for samurai description and samurai villages and that sort of stuff, and warmers and everything, this is a little bit of exaggeration of going into sort of, you know, halfway into Hollywood style. But that kind of, Kurosawa always did that, you know, researched a lot, and then using all those research pieces as a base, and then sort of using poetic justice to go a little bit farther. And Ed is inheriting such kind of technique from Kurosawa. So we were really impressed by Ed's approach to the every aspect of this film.
Right. Your character could be viewed as a bit of a villain in this.
He's definitely a villain.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
I wanted to do villain kind of thing, but Ed prohibited me to do any of those, you know, facial...
Right.
expressions, and so sort of, you know, played it a little bit less, but it's fun.